Anne of Bogge here again. Now with my haul from the store Action. That's a very cheap store here in Holland. Well, you can get all sorts of things. So let's begin. I bought some of these. These are glue tape rollers, and well, I go through them like crazy, so I bought three of these. Here's my cat, Buster. Hey, Buster. He wants to be with us. Can you hear him purr? Purr, purr, purr. No. You can stay on the couch. Right there. Okay. Well, next one. I bought some, well, a load of stickers. And these are very pretty embossed stickers. Well, I'm going to show you. Look how pretty. And then there's two sheets in every one, so this is the back, and the other one was the front. And then I bought this one. This is the front, and this is the back. And as you can see, they're vintage. I really have a vintage addiction at the moment, so. Here we go, this is the next one, and the back, well, I got two of those, and then the next one, beautiful vintage flowers, and there are also glitters and things on this, look how pretty. So I got also two of these. And then these are very vintage, very pretty, little angel vintage. And then the back, more angels. Isn't it pretty? And I've got two of those. And again, some pretty vintage flowers. And on the back, some flower children. All vintage looking, and I bought two of these as well. And then the last set, also angels. Look how pretty. Aren't they gorgeous? And I bought two of these as well. The other two, the first two, they didn't have two, so that's why I bought one of those. Let's see, I've been looking for some new glitter gel pens for a while now, and I did find them at Intertoys, that's a children's store here, but they cost like €4, so I thought, well, I don't know about that. So I found them at the Action, and these were €1.89, and well, I have to find out if they if you can use them on paper as well. I think so, but these are tattoo gel pens, tattoo glitter gel pens. So these are the colors: gold, silver, pink, blue, gold. And there are some stencils with it. And let's see. Oh. Of course, there's a sticker in the back. Okay. And it was in the children's section, but I don't know. It's children proof. It's wonder proof. I've got to open it. I don't know. Maybe I have to cut it. I think it needs to be cut, but I don't know. The stencils, I wanted to look at the stencils, but well, they're in the background, so we will see what kind of stencils are in there. I can't get it open now. I need to have some scissors with me, and I don't. So I've got some gel pens now. Well, let's show these. I've been saving a lot of things and things and things, and well, I just was in need of more storage, so I bought two more of these. And then next up, some more vintage things. Let's see. Let's do this one. I thought this would be a very pretty vintage cardstock. Let's just show you. It's like this. Look how pretty. And you can use it for vintage. Look at it. It's very vintage. Look how pretty. And they're all, well, vintage looking. This one very pretty as well. There's glitter on it. If you can see. Yes. This color. Look how pretty. So that's one. And then I've got a vintage glory. It's a little tiny booklet. Look how pretty vintage. Yes, next one. Oh. Yes, that's another one. That's another one. Vintage. Very vintage. All vintage looking. Very pretty. This one, you can see it go from pink to brown, and another one. And I've got two of these because I really like this one. And then, well, this is a vintage romance, vintage. Let's see. Very pretty one. Dots. Words. Look how pretty. This one, very cute. Again, some words, scribblings. And oop. This is the last one. Book text. Okay, this is Colorful Fairy Tales, but well, I thought these were very vintage as well, so I've got a load of vintage stuff right now. Look how vintage that is. Very pretty. Look, this is vintage. 99 is Luchtballons. Well, I think it's like 30 Luchtballons. So, well, these are very vintage as well, so they're pretty. Oh, some scribble text, very vintage. And the last one is also very vintage. And then we've got travel memories, and well, some of these are vintage, some of them are not really, but like this one. I don't think it's very vintage, but look, this one's very pretty. And I like this one with all the post stamps. This one does look very vintage. This one is cute, vintage things. Some scribble text. Look how pretty. Cool. And then this one, travel stuff. And the last one, very pretty. It was the last one, wasn't it? Yes, it was. So, very pretty. And then, next up. I'm trying to do it quick, but some more vintage things. So these are pearl stickers, and I thought these would be very lovely as vintage ones. And then, I'm sorry, I moved the camera. I found these vintage stickers, and they're well, they're metallic kind, but this. These were the last ones I could find. I think they don't have them at the Action anymore. That's a pity, because I've got two sets of these for a very long time, and now when I'm going to use them for the very first time, they don't have them in stock anymore. Oh well, I had to grab down on the shelf behind, far behind in the shelf, to get this one. I found another one, but that one was damaged. All the those were flowers with very big leaves, and all the flowers were crooked and bent, and so I didn't take that one. So this is the last one. So they've got some new clear stamps and die cut sets, and well, they had more, but I only took these ones. Look how pretty. So this one can go in this one. And then you've got some pretty background stamps. I really like this one with the scribbles and little hearts. So you can stamp and then die cut them out, or just use these to die cut other things out. And then I really love these ones as well. Look, so they've got a bigger middle and a small little butterfly, and then I've got the matching stamps, and then some background stamps. So you can choose, or you do this and then cut it out, or you can do this and cut that. So those were the stamp die cut sets, and then some more vintage things. They've got some new ones, and the old ones I couldn't find anymore. But these are pretty as well, so I've got some pretty ones. Oh, can you see that? That's better. Yes. This one, a little tipping over. I think this one very pretty. This one. Look how pretty. Little kitty cat. And this one. Little scissors. So, and then, well, I almost used up my self-adhesive ribbon. So I went there and I bought every set I wanted. So I've got a little pink one, and this is off-white or beige with a pink ribbon in it. And then we've got a white and a beige with a blue ribbon in it. I've got a purple and well, is it? Yes, this is also beige with purple ribbon in it, and I've got the blue with a white and a blue ribbon in it. These ones looked the same, so... Oh wait, I've got two the same. Because this one, I thought there were two of those in there, but if you look, there's a white one. And I peeked and it's the same. But well, we can always use some more, so I've got these two. And then I thought this one was very pretty as well, so I've got a bigger one, a bigger one of the beige one, and then a smaller white one with a purple ribbon. So those were the ribbon, self-adhesive ribbons. And then the last, but not least, I still had a coupon for the action for my birthday in October, and I saved this, and well, look, I've got a sewing machine. It's a very little tiny sewing machine. I thought it would be, well, very, very fun to play with in my art, so... I read the description in the store, and it said it was for very light stuff, so I really hope I can sew, how do you say that, well, I'm a little off at the moment. I'm happy with it, yay! But I wanted to, I saw some people, I thought, yes, Gina and Cindy use their sewing machine for paper sewing. Yes, paper. That's a difficult word, paper. But well, Cindy did have a very cute little sewing machine, and before I saw hers, I already saw this one, but well, I had to wait to get it, and now I have it, and it's a very cute little one. As you can see, does it have measurements? I don't know. Doesn't have measurements. Well, the box. Let's see. The box is, well, 12. A little bit more is 12. 12 1/4 by 11 1/2. So. It's a very tiny machine, because that's the box, so it's even smaller. So I hope I can use it for for paper, sewing on paper, as for when I buy trousers, they are always too long. And I do have a sewing machine, but the way it goes into the machine, I always drew it wrong. And I really hope this one is easier to do, because well, I just can't do the other one. I always end up, like, if you have the seam, it's always bulky. But well, I can go to the sewer here in town, but it's like 7.50 or 10 euros to do both leg openings. So I think that's very expensive. So I thought, well, maybe I can do it with this one myself now. And I've got some dog toys that need to be sewn. So, Alba can play with this board. Oh, I'm so happy. I want to hug it. I'm going to hug it. Don't mind me. I'm just so happy with my little sewing machine. Yay. I'm sorry. But I'm just going to wait now. But I think I'm going to open it and well, let you see while I'm opening it. But I'm not going to do it now. I'm now going to have my lunch. So thank you very, very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. I enjoy my new things. So well, thank you again for watching. I hope to see you in the next video. I want to tell you that I've made a new blog. The other one, well, it's just too hard for me to put something on there. Well, it's too much work for me, so I haven't been updating that one. And that was from blogspot.nl. And well, it took too long, too much time for me to upload. So I made a new blog, and this is my Facebook blog, and it will be in the description box below in every video. So I hope you will go and check out my new blog. And I also pronounced my new name, and I want to do that in this video as well. I've chosen a craft name, and that's going to be, and it's in Dutch, because, well, I'm going to tell you why, but I'm first going to tell you what it is. It's Thea Art, and it's written, well, if you go to the blog, you can see how it's written. Thea Art, for the English speaking people, Thea Art, Thea, was the name of my mother, and in honor of my mother, which I inherited my craft joy from, or my craft skills, my art skills. Well, it's in honor of my mother. My mother passed away in 2011, and I'm a little bit better, but still having a little bit of a hard time with it. You can see, maybe you can see, the people who know me can see that I'm getting a little bit teared up right now. But I will change my YouTube name to Thea Art by Wanda van Bogerijen. But I want to make an art piece with the name on it, so I can use it in front of the video. So my new art name, or my art name, is Thea Art, or Thea Art. So it's spelled like T Heart of the Art, and it's written like Thea Art, because of my mother. I hope she will be proud, happy. So, okay. Thank you very much for watching, and enjoy creating, because I will. Have a very, very nice day, and until the next video, please remember to give me those thumbs up to help my channel grow. Subscribe if you aren't yet, and share. Please share my videos around. Bye.